Now you say most, are there any negative experiences like having nightmares or, you know, just horror, but like not good?
Yeah. And, you know, it's, we were pretty naive because we measured come pretty, not neither, whatever. And it, about 16% of people have a non-comforting experience. But it's really interesting is those are often the most transformational or meaningful. And some of this is captured on film, which is really wonderful to see. So I'll give you an example. We had a guy who was in his 40s who had spent most of his life in and out of in prison, more in prison than out. He had drug addictions. And he had head and neck cancer, and he was dreaming. And we caught this on film by accident, really. We're just interviewing for another topic. And he's joking. He was very jovial. He's one of these guys who couldn't afford to live with regret or look backwards. And then he starts crying because he's having these horrible dreams. He's being stabbed by all the people he's hurt at the sight of his cancer. And he breaks down. But then when he comes out of it, he asks to see a daughter that he wanted to express his love towards and apologize. And after that, he slept. So these dreams don't deny life. We had a mother whose worth was questioned as because two of her kids were in prison for drug-related offenses. And in her end of life, she's back in her home in Puerto Rico, and her parents come to her and tell her what a good mother and what a good person she was. So again, they're not denying that bad things and painful things transpire, but they address them and soothe them in a way that's very interesting.
So it's not like if you have a negative experience, quote unquote negative experience, it's not there to punish you. It's there to guide you into a positive scenario, like that example you gave with the 40-year-old who had that horrible dream, but then that prompted him to make amends in a positive thing. And once he was able to release that, he slept.
He died peacefully. Yeah.
Yeah. So you haven't had any, in your research, you haven't found any like punishing, like I'm just getting beaten with these bad dreams for no reason.
No, we have. I talk about the most powerful one in my TED talk, where a guy, he had been involved in the invasion of Normandy at the age of 16 or 17.
Oh, Jesus.
And his whole life had been, he'd been suffered with PTSD and he never got help. He kept it all to himself. His wife knew because he'd scream in the night. And so he came into our unit at the end of his life because he was having such horrific experiences where he's seen body parts and bloody water and screams, and he couldn't rest. You can't die really unless you can sleep. It's pretty hard to do because you have to pass in sleep. So he couldn't sleep. And then one day I go in to see him, and he slept. And I said, well, what did you dream about? He was in our study. He goes, well, I had a great dream, he said, where I relived the best day of my life, which was the day he got his discharge papers. And he said, and I had a really good dream. He said, I was on a beach, presumably Normandy, and a soldier who he didn't know came up to him and said, now we're going to come get you. So that sense of that he abandoned people had kind of gone full circle. And he slept peacefully after that, and he died peacefully.
To watch the full video, click on the link below. And don't forget to subscribe.